Johannes Kepler is the father of modern astronomy and a major figure in the birth of science. He was a devout and profoundly spiritual man who studied theology and had a lifelong drive to understand the structure of creation. He believed that geometry and symmetry were built into the fundamental architecture of the universe. Kepler is most famous for deducing that the orbits of the planets around the Sun are shaped like ellipses. His advances in astronomy laid the foundation for the scientific revolution brought about by Isaac Newton. Kepler also wrote the first modern treatise on the science of optics and was first to understand how the eye's lens focuses an image on the retina. Science was in its infancy in Kepler's time, and Kepler's books are a mixture of deep and valuable insights mingled with ideas that today seem fanciful and very strange indeed. But in many ways, Kepler was the ideal modern scientist. He never hid his mistakes and modestly discussed all the blind alleys he explored before reaching his final conclusions. In 1611, Kepler was invited to the New Year's celebrations of his friend, Johannes Matthias Wacker von Wackenfels, privy councillor to Rudolf II, the Holy Roman Emperor. Kepler later recalled, while musing over a suitable New Year's gift for his friend, by a happy chance, water vapour was condensed by the cold into snow, and specks of down fell here and there on my coat, all with six corners and feathered radii. Upon my word, here was something smaller than any drop, yet with a pattern. Here was the ideal New Year's gift, the very thing for a mathematician to give, since it comes down from heaven and looks like a star. Unable to preserve a delicate and beautiful snow crystal as his present, Kepler decided to write a little booklet about the snowflake and its symmetry in honour of his friend. This booklet is called Deneva Sexangula, the six-cornered snowflake. Kepler realised that although the exact shape of the icy filigree of each snow crystal is different, they all display the same hexagonal symmetry. It was the origin of this symmetry that intrigued him. In the booklet, he looked for clues in the geometrical structure of other familiar symmetrical objects such as rock crystals, bees' honeycombs, and the seed cases of pomegranates. Remarkably, Kepler's conclusions were essentially correct. The symmetrical shape of crystals is due to the regular arrangement of the atoms from which they are formed. This was almost 300 years before scientists even established the existence of atoms. Kepler was keen to associate regular geometrical figures to the structure of the universe. In particular, he analysed the Platonic solids, or regular polyhedra. These are polyhedra whose faces are all of the same type of regular polygon. Kepler also considered polygons whose edges intersect each other, and these polygons he named star polygons or stellated polygons, the name by which we know them still today. Stellated polygons have been inscribed on amulets and talismans since antiquity. They have long associations with magic and power. The witch's circle is constructed around a pentagram. Magic charms show pentagrams and heptagrams. Indeed, it is difficult to find images of pentagrams on the internet that do not have occult associations. The seal of Solomon or Star of David is a hexagram, and the flags of many nations include stars and stripes. And police and military badges often have these shapes. Stellated polygons are found embedded in stunning Islamic tessellations, created as visions of the infinite underlying geometry of the universe. Kepler sought to describe the universe in terms of elegant mathematics. He described his investigations in his book, The Harmony of the Universe. And in the book, he described two regular polyhedra whose faces are stellated polygons. Kepler mused that perhaps stars might have shapes such as these. The small stellated dodecahedron has 12 pentagram faces that intersect each other, with five of these faces meeting at each vertex. This is shown in the mosaic by Paolo Uccello, created in 1430, which is built into the floor of St. Mark's Basilica in Venice. Kepler also found the large stellated dodecahedron, which has 20 pentagram faces, with three of these faces meeting at each vertex. The French physicist and mathematician Louis Poinsot, who lived from 1777 to 1859, discovered two new polyhedra that are closely related to those identified by Kepler. Their faces are ordinary regular polygons, not stellated polygons, but each face intersects several other faces, so they are also regarded as stellated polyhedra. The great dodecahedron has 12 pentagonal faces, and the great icosahedron has 20 triangular faces. These four regular stellated polyhedra are known today as the Kepler-Poinsot polyhedra. Kepler's belief in divine symmetry has proved to be a valuable insight into the laws of the universe. Everywhere that physicists have looked, symmetry plays a vital role in the structure of physics, from Einstein's theories of relativity to the Standard Model, which is our best theory of particle physics and the structure of matter. Symmetry is at their heart. But whereas the symmetry of a snowflake is obvious to the eye, these deeper symmetries are often based on abstract, higher dimensional geometries. The best candidate that we have for an ultimate theory describing the structure of fundamental particles and the forces that act on them is known as string theory. This is a theory where the fundamental particles are each different types of vibration of one fundamental entity, the string. So when the string vibrates in one way, we might see it as an electron, and when it vibrates in another way, we might see it as a quark or a photon. A curious feature of string theory is that it only works in 10-dimensional space-time. To describe the physics of the real universe, string theorists assume that 6 of the 9 spatial dimensions are curled up so tightly we are not aware of them. Even so, these extra dimensions might determine the properties of the particles and forces we see in particle accelerator experiments. According to string theorists, the 6 extra dimensions form a shape known as a Calabi-Yau manifold. This animation is a 3-dimensional projection of one of these shapes, known as a quintic hypersurface. String theory remains an intriguing but unproven approach to physics, so this is all highly speculative. As yet, there is no experimental evidence to connect string theory to the structure of the real universe. So no one knows whether it is in the same class as some of the brilliant insights of Johannes Kepler, or whether it will eventually be dismissed just like some of his other curious and wacky ideas. Thank you for watching the video. Call back again soon for more adventures from the Cosmic Mystery Talk.